Ever You, Ever Me is a powerful book written by David Leviathan about a depressed teenager named Evan. The book is just filled with sentence fragments and chapter fragments and lines that are left unfinished, and it's just awesome. It's a great way to read thoughts directly from a kid. In this book, there are also a lot of pictures. Leviathan asks his friend and photographer, Jonathan Farmer, to contribute the pictures that are scattered throughout the book, and these photos try to help the reader get into the story. But, as Evan says, as you probably already noticed in the beginning of the video, over half the words are crossed out in this novel. Leviathan wrote this book in a first-person point of view, which ends up being a dialogue between Evan and his best friend Ariel. Of course, since it's thoughts from a teenager, there are many sentence fragments and incomplete thoughts, many of which get crossed out when Evan realizes that it's not exactly something he wants to say out loud. Lastly, what really makes the story possible is that Evan's best friend Ariel, whom he loved far more than anything else in the world, is gone. Evan can tell you everything about Ariel. He knew her better than anyone else in the world, even better than Jack. Or so he thought. Really, the only thing Evan has inside of him is memories. So the basic plot of the book involves Evan going and finding these envelopes that have either photographs or notes in them, and he just begins to obsess over it. Well, this one time when he found this envelope, this is what he thought. So how does it end? Well, I can't tell you, but here's something to think about until you can pick up the book. When I was reading this book, I really found it very captivating. This book was just fantastic. Even though it's meant for young adult readers, I was really enjoying myself all the way through the story. Even though it's a little bit emo and it's meant for young adult readers, I just really got into it. I really loved it. I would definitely recommend this book to anyone who has time to read.